The Education Committee has been very busy this summer, and we are not slowing down. For the third consecutive year, the White River Valley Historical Society has taught a local history and research class to the students at the Forsyth Boys and Girls Club. This has been a successful program, with the same young people taking the course multiple years. Because of the interest, we offer differing areas of study each year. This year, we had two groups of participants, an older group and a younger group. Our focus was the Old Forsyth Cemetery, which is located on Coy Boulevard just past the Boys and Girls Club. Each student chose a person buried in the cemetery to become their adopted cousin. The people included were of the Boswell, Hart, Parrish, Morton, Johnson, Groom, Houseman, and Weatherman families, as well as others. Each participant was to research their new cousin, and they were given a picture of the person to make a visual connection. After a brief overview of the layout of the cemetery, care of tombstones, and the meanings of various inscriptions, each participant made a tombstone rubbing and had their photographs taken at the individual tombstones of their adopted cousin. The older group of participants met at the Boys and Girls Club in the computer lab to continue their research. Miss Leslie introduced them to the various internet sites available for historical and genealogical research. Each of the students researched information about their cousin on the White River Valley Historical Society website, the Missouri Secretary of State's website, Find a Grave website, Family Search website, and many others. They were amazed at the information available to them. Miss Leslie simply amazed both groups of participants with her walking tour of Old Forsyth, located where Shadow Rock Park is today. They were shown pictures of Old Forsyth while standing in the very spot where the photographs were taken over 50 years ago. This gave them the unique opportunity to better picture what the town looked like before being moved to its present location. The young people also discovered the sidewalks and foundation stones and the 1890 block of the old courthouse, as well as exploring the Gem and Mineral Club's fountain. Each student was then given a picture of Old Forsyth for them to keep. After touring Old Forsyth, the participants repeated the experience at the current location, with Miss Leslie letting the young people compare historic pictures of the site to the way it looks today. The students were extremely intrigued by the old movie theater, especially as Miss Leslie and Miss Tammy told them stories about watching movies there when they were young. They also toured the Presbyterian Church, where they saw the stained glass windows with family names. Some were the family of their adopted cousin. They all loved the old bell, which is over 100 years old and was originally located in Old Forsyth. They were amazed that the same bell still rings every Sunday morning. The tour was followed up with a younger group at the Historical Society, where they colored pictures of historic buildings in Forsyth. The older group continued on to the Forsyth Library, where Miss Doreen and her helpers were waiting to assist them as they continued to research their new cousins. Each person had a turn at learning to use the microfilm and the various documents available in the genealogy section of the library. This older group also had the opportunity to conduct research at the Historical Society. Different learning stations were set up for them to learn to use the DocuWare system, as well as the other materials available, including old newspapers and the documents compiled by Jody Gideon. Miss Leslie, Miss Doreen, Miss Tammy, Mr. Dusty, and Miss Julie from the Boys and Girls Club helped the students at the various stations. To wrap up the course, the younger students completed mazes on their cousins and created scrapbooks about them and their lives in Taney County. The older group prepared flip charts about their cousins and presented their findings on the last day.